that's another big one, and I feel that deeply, is the fear of taking too much time apart from the partner or the children. And I had to deal with that, and I still am dealing with that, because it's true. There are moments where you're like, where I was like so into this new business that I was totally not thinking about my husband, for example. Like, I was totally not there with my head, even when I was there. So I wasn't enjoying dinner or watching a movie, just being with him. Mm. And actually, I wasn't there, right? Because this meant so much for me, and there was so much at stake. Mm-hmm. So how do you overcome that fear? For me, thanks to you, it was maybe taking like some days where I, or like hours of my day where I dedicate my time to my partner. And mm-hmm. that's not negotiable. Mm-hmm. That's our time. Like, the me time is very important too. And I struggled with that too, because once mm-hmm. I'm all in something, that's the only thing that it exists, and it's not healthy.
Mm.
Right?
Yes. Yes.
So how do you deal with being afraid of taking too much time away from your family?
I think this is a very realistic fear. And as you said, you have it as well. And I think this is something that everyone needs to check in with themselves all the time. But as you said, this is a decision again. And this is more a management thing than a mindset thing, yes. actually. Because it requires discipline, but also open communication. What are our ideals? What would I love to have in a perfect world? But what are our non-negotiables? Like you said, like, this is the bare minimum that we need. And it's not only about quantity, it's about quality as well. Like, people can spend hours next to each other watching Netflix, and they are not going to have quality time together. But then again, it would be better to spend this time working on your business, and then take the time every, for example, have a fixed date for your partner where you are going to go on a date, like cinema, right. or take each other out and go for a nice meal in a new restaurant, which is something special. This is much more of quality time than just spending a lot of time with each other, but not being present really. And a lot of people are not really present also, even if they don't follow their purpose or don't follow their goals and dreams.
And I think it's the same with kids. It's not just with the partner, always. Right? So same, like, if you are there but not really, then mm-hmm. isn't it better to work on your business and have time where you're really there?
Yeah. Right?
Instead of being there all the time, but not really.
Yeah, but I think the fundament of this is open communication.
Yes.
Like, not being afraid. You don't have to get it right by yourself. Ask your partner. Ask your children as well, like, Mommy is going to have a big project now, but she doesn't want to neglect you. What do you appreciate most? Like, and for one child, it can be the bedtime story, which are a non-negotiable. For the other child, it can be something completely else. But it is these things you have to ask people, right. and you have to be open about it. And then, of course, be strategic about it and make it a discipline. I know how hard it was for you to set boundaries with yourself and be like, no, I'm going to stand up and take a walk. Like, yeah. lunchtime, I'm going to take a walk. And it was really hard. And it is for most people. Most people even forget to eat. Like, no, you have to have your non-negotiable. Yeah. Again.
Drink. Now I don't anymore. But
yes. Yeah. But you have to have your non-negotiables.
Yeah.
And this is very, very, you can work on that. This is not something that you need to be afraid of, because it is a looming thing. This is something that you can create and like influence perfectly.
Yeah. And saying like, okay, I don't have kids, so it must have been easy mm-hmm. for me that someone that has kids. But I was working full time. I had a husband and I was opening my own business. I know one of my students had 5 kids, a husband. Mm-hmm. with his own company. And she was able, after our course, to open not one, but 3 businesses, and they're working.
Oh, great.
So
wow.
It's really about managing. And if you can help, I would suggest Annalisa Stella or Marta Alcini. They're very good on Instagram, and they are really good at helping you because they're professional organizer and they mm-hmm. help with managing your time. And they are really good at for example, with Annalisa, I literally at one time looked at my calendar. I did that with you actually as well. And like, I started having like yellow spots for my break times.
Yes.
Because I couldn't take them by myself. It was just not happening. If I would just say, yeah, I'm going to have two breaks a day, that was not happening.
No.
So I had to put them in my calendar and just force myself to be like, drop everything. It's time to have a break. You can come back later.
Yeah.
Because sometimes we're so into it that it's really hard to just drop it. I sometimes finish at 8 p.m. just because I don't want to drop it, but I can do it tomorrow.
Yes.
So it's really about self-discipline, and I'm still working on that.
Yeah, well, it is hard because also like follow your passion means like when you're passionate, just go all in. But no, you wouldn't, if you had the most delicious meal, you wouldn't eat the whole table as well right away.
Yeah.
You can't do this because you're going to be sick afterwards. This is the same thing with work. It's with everything like this. Yeah. You have to be, time management is so important. And these are the three things I think that are the basis of it. Open communication, strategic and disciplined action taking, and then delegating whatever you can delegate that you do not want to make. And if this means like asking a friend to do something for you, or even if you can afford it, to get someone to do it for you and pay for it. And you don't have to pay for someone to do something in your business if this is something that you are still working on and figuring out. But for example, I know an entrepreneur who, she said like it's either her business or her children, and the thing that is taking up a lot of time is doing the laundry, and she is paying like $10 a week to someone who does her laundry. I mean, and I think these $10 are worth it to have the time with your children. So she was very creative, because oftentimes we think it's either our children, either our partner, or our business, but sometimes it's something completely else that you can get rid of.
Yes. And it's really about priority, I feel like. Like, what are your priorities in life? Is it like stay with your partner or kids and work, or I don't know, having fun and stay with your kids, or like having free time and stay with your kids? Then maybe don't invest in a course right now, because that's not your priority. But if your priority is starting a business, well, you have to make time to work on it, to learn, to spend a lot of time on it. And I feel like seeing my 6 months, and as a lot of big coaches say that, it's about seasons as well. There are going to be seasons where your work takes priority, and other seasons where your work can be just okay, just there, but your kids and family takes priority for a time. And you need to be good, very good, and that's not easy, at managing these seasons and not freak out every time it changes, because it's going to be like that, I guess.
This is the tricky part about it, and this is the tricky part about any journey. It's not constant. It's not linear. And we want to reach this kind of balance where we know, okay, this amount of time I'm going to dedicate this to the business, and this amount of time is going to be dedicated to this, and it's going to be this way. And then something happens, because life happens, and then something changes, or you get a new idea and new opportunity, and all of a sudden it's completely different again. Right. And like I said, it's seasons. You have to be okay with it being, yes, up and down and shifting. And if you can think about it like a pie, and you can even, this could be a coaching prompt for this exercise or for this question, to draw a pie and like be honest with yourself. At this moment, how much of this pie should be dedicated to my business? How much of this pie, of this circle, should be dedicated to my partner? How much to my children? How much to my health as well? Because let's not forget about ourselves.
Yes, I forget about
that. A lot of people like to think about their clients and their services and products, and then about everyone else. And then in the end, they are kind of tired and burned out and ask themselves why. Yeah, they forgot about themselves.
Yes.
So ask yourself, what are the things that enrich you, that fill you up with energy? And sometimes this can be time apart and by yourself or with other people.
I feel like also a business is not for, opening a business is not for everyone.
Oh no, not at all.
So it's okay if it's not for you. It's okay if you realize that that's not you. I feel like to me, when I was working for someone else, I did kind of felt like it wasn't for me, but I mean, everyone works for someone. Mm-hmm. Then now that I'm in this position where I work for myself, I'm like, I was born for this. This is me, you know? But some other people don't feel like this. They hate it.
This is perfectly fine as long as you know who you are. This is why it requires so much self-awareness. Some of the smartest people that I know are actually not becoming entrepreneurs, even though they know they could do it.
Yeah.
They're not becoming entrepreneurs because they know that the way they work, they can do much more and be more effective and have a bigger impact when working in a different setting. They joined a big company and are having a very important, like they are very advanced in their career because they know what they want and they know that this is the right field for them to affect change and to do it in this way, but they had to know who they are.
It depends on, I always feel like it's about priorities.
Yes.
And if you fear about taking too much time, just know that there is time for everything. It's just a management thing and priority thing. Like
and
what is most important.
Thing. And quality thing. I would always choose 2 special hours with my partner, like doing something exciting and something that I'm not doing every day, over 10 hours lying on the sofa and watching Netflix without realizing even what I'm watching. It's the quality of the time as well that you invest in something. You can work in your business 25 hours and have the output that you would have done in 2 hours as well. You need to be, and this is why a productivity coach could be also useful, because maybe you are investing so much time because you don't know how to do it more efficient.
Yes.
Not because it's necessary to do it this way.
Totally. And like, for example, for me, the first 3 months I was studying and setting up my business and working full time. So it was a season where I kind of like just saw my husband 15 minutes a day. And I wasn't okay with that, but I knew it was going to end. And as soon as I could, I took away Sunday from, I was working 7 days a week.
Mm.
I took Sunday away and I was like, okay, that's my husband and my time or my family time. Sunday is sacred now and I'm not working on Sunday ever. So I'm doing everything I can to not have to work on Sunday, and that's not going to happen.
I can still remember the session in which we talked about this, because you looked at your vision board and you were so tired and you looked at your vision board and you said, wait a second, independence, time and family are so high on that. And I'm just working all the time. I'm dependent, completely dependent on what is happening in my business and with a second job as well that you had at that time. And then also like in like, family was nowhere to be seen. You didn't have time for your partner. You didn't have time for friends, family, whatever.
Yes.
So reconnecting with the part of you that knew why you were doing it also helped you to change it again a little bit.
Totally.
It's okay. And it's okay to get lost short for a while. It's like, it's okay to not have the perfect balance all the time. You just need to know when to check in again.
Yes. Yes. Mm. And remember your why again, because that's what happened when I saw the vision board. I was like, wait, I'm doing all of this for my family and I'm not looking at my family. So
yeah.
There's something wrong there.
Something is disconnected.
Yeah. So I got time for my family, and that happened thanks to you too. And Annalisa, I have to say, like, and I got all the tools I could to actually make it, because it did look like it was impossible for me to have Sundays off. And if I really wanted this thing to work, I had to. But I had to for a limited time. And then I didn't have to anymore. And it's not going to happen ever again.
Well, yes, set yourself a limit. Like set yourself a limit of 2 to 3 weeks and then check in with yourself. And if you realize, okay, I need 1 or 2 more weeks, okay. But always make sure which level of exhaustion you are at, because it can get dangerous. People push themselves so far that they burn out without it being necessary. Oftentimes it's like an inner pressure thing.
Again, it's like quality, time management and priorities.
Yeah. And sometimes it's the simplest things, like 5 minutes in the morning, a little tea in between can really be a big change and do a lot of like me appreciation and avoid problems, but we don't know how to do this in between.